Hello everyone, Alex here from WarrenOffKeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a very basic giveaway command. So in this channel, I have this simple message here. We're giving away a free subscription to Skillshare for a year. Obviously this is just an example. And once you have a message like this, you might want users to be able to easily add a reaction to it. So within this video, you're going to learn how you can do exclamation point start giveaway, and then we might have some type of emoji here. And that's going to automatically add that reaction. Then anyone can react to it very easily with just one single click. And whenever you want to end the giveaway, you can do exclamation point end giveaway. And it's going to automatically select a winner. Now you can then tag this user or do whatever you want with this user, but it'll randomly select a winner from the amount of people who have reacted, not including the bot. So you're always going to select a real user. So real quick, before we actually get started, if you do need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warren Off Keys Discord. I'll try my best to help you if you post on either of those two places. So I'm actually going to go to my reactions here, and I'm going to get rid of these two. Then I'm going to stop my bot, and we're going to start writing some code. So we're going to be using the Commando framework within this video. If you don't know anything about that, then a link to a video where I show you how to use Commando will be in the video description. Also, if you want access to this project here, you can view it on the GitHub repository, which can also be found in the video description. The first thing we need to do is go into our main index file. Scrolling down, we see our groups. We need to actually create a giveaway group. So I'm going to add a new group within this array. We'll call this giveaway. Then the description will be commands to manage giveaways. I can then save this and close this. And then I can go inside my commands, and we see we have some folders here. I'm going to make a new folder for giveaways. And then within this, I'm going to make a new file called start-giveaway.js. So here we need to actually import Commando. So constant Commando equals require discord.js-commando. Now we need to actually export a command. So we can say module.exports. This is going to be a class. We'll call this start giveaway command. Now this class is going to extend another class, so extends, and that class is going to be commando.command. Then we have our opening curly braces. Now we can create our constructor, and this is going to have a client argument. Within here, we need to call the constructor of our command class. So to access the constructor for a class you are extending, you can use super. And then we can pass in our client, and then we have some options here. Now within here, the name is going to be start giveaway. The group giveaway. This should be the exact thing we put inside of our index. We can then have our member name, which will be start giveaway again. And then we can have our description, which will be starts a giveaway. Now we want to make sure that only certain people can run this. We don't want anyone to start a giveaway. So we can say user permissions. This is going to be an array with administrator being the only permission we want. Of course, you can add in whatever permission you want within here. Now we want an asynchronous run function, and this is going to be ran whenever our command is called. So within here, we're going to want a message object and an arguments object. The very first thing we want to do is actually delete the message. So we can do message.delete. Whoops, not that. Message.delete. And then this is going to return a promise that we can listen to, and this dot then function is going to be called whenever this message is actually deleted. So here we have access to a function. So within here, we now need to access the guild and the channel from the message. So we can actually destructure those from the message. So guild and channel, these are different properties of the message object. So we can access them using destructuring like this. We then want to fetch the latest message within this channel. So we can say channel.messages.fetch, and this can return an object. We can say limit is 1. And this is the reason why we actually deleted the message and then had a .then, which is only going to be ran after the message is actually deleted, because we want to get the message that's directly before it. So I'm going to minimize my console here to make more room. This is going to also return a promise, so we can use .then, and we're going to get a messages object. Now within here, we want to actually gain access to the first message. So I'm going to reuse this message object here. So I can say message equals messages.first. Now we want to make sure that that actually exists. So if this becomes an empty channel, then we want to complain to the user. We can say if not message, then we can say channel.send. There are no messages. You can add in whatever error message you want here. And then I'm going to return. That way we don't run the rest of our code. Now afterwards, we know that there's going to be a message here. And so we can simply say message.react with args, which is going to be an actual reaction. Let's go ahead and test this real quick. We can save this. I can go into my bots. I can run it with node index.js. Okay, so I noticed that I misspelled discord.js. So let's go ahead and save that. Make sure you spell discord.js-commando correctly, of course. I can then restart my bot. Everything seems to be working. Going into here, I could do exclamation point start giveaway, and I can add in a fire reaction. And it's going to remove my message and then add in a fire reaction. However, if I do start giveaway and then add in a custom reaction such as JavaScript, that's actually not going to work. Now, to figure out why, we can go down and we can console log the arguments. This will give us a better idea of what's happening here. I can save the code and restart the bot. I'm going to try adding a fire reaction again. So start giveaway and then fire. And then I can use start giveaway and then JavaScript. And so scrolling up, we see that the giveaway is actually a real reaction, a real emoji, which is not displaying correctly inside of the console. That's fine though. But then our arguments for our custom one is this type of syntax here. We can very easily get access to the real emoji by accessing the name. So to do that, we are simply going to see if the args, which is our emoji, has a colon. So we see here, we see two colons on either side. And so to see if this string is going to contain a colon, we can say if args.includes, and then pass in single quotes and then a colon. Now at this point, we know that we're dealing with an actual custom emoji, and we want to actually split the string into an array. So I can say const split equals args.split colon. So let's say we have this actual string right here. That's then going to become an array with less than sign, JavaScript, and then the ID. So we want to gain access to the first element. So this is index 0, this is index 1. So we want to gain access to the name. So I can say constant emoji name equals split index 1. Now we want to gain access to the actual emoji, and we're going to store that within the args array. So we're going to reuse this, so message.react args will still make sense and will still work. We can say args equals guild, which is why we destructured it here on line 16. Guild.emojis.cache.find, and this is going to give us a callback. And this callback will be ran amongst every single emoji on the server, and so we're going to have an emoji as the argument here. We're then going to return true or false depending on if this is the emoji we want. As soon as we return true, it's going to stop trying to search through all the emojis, and it's going to simply return that emoji into our arguments variable right here. So we can simply say return emoji.name is exactly equal to emoji name. So emoji.name is accessing the name property among whatever emoji we are looping through at the moment. And then emoji name is our actual string that we pulled from the actual arguments from the user. Now at this point, args is going to equal whatever emoji we actually have. I can save this and I can restart my bot. Going back, so we already know that built-in emojis work. However, now we're going to try the JavaScript one, which is a custom one to the WarnOffKeys Discord. So start giveaway JavaScript. Oops, okay, I misspelled that. Start giveaway JavaScript. There we go. You see the message is removed and another JavaScript reaction is added. So I'm actually going to go in and remove that because we just want one reaction. Future reactions will actually be ignored anyway, but that's just an example of how you're going to use built-in emojis and custom emojis. Now at this point, users can go in and click on this to enter the giveaway, but now I need a second command called endGiveaway, which is going to actually end the giveaway and randomly select a winner. I'm going to make a new file called end-giveaway.js, and we're going to use a lot of similar code to this file here when it comes to the permissions and the message checks and all of that. So I'm going to copy everything within this file and I'm going to paste it in here. Scrolling up, we can obviously change start giveaway to end giveaway and down here as well. And then instead of starts a giveaway, we can say ends a giveaway. Now the actual class can be renamed to end giveaway. And then scrolling down, Everything after this if statement can actually be removed. So this if statement with the args and then our message react, we can actually get rid of those. Now we're no longer using args, so we can get rid of this argument here. So we just have our message. And then we're also no longer using guild, so we can get rid of that as well. Then we're ready to actually get all of the users who have reacted. And there's a few different steps we have to do this. The first one is going to be changing this function to an asynchronous function so we can use await within this function. I'm actually going to minimize my console here. So we're going to get access to the users based off of the message reactions. So to do this, we're actually going to destructure users from await message.reactions. We're going to access the reactions for the message, .cache.first. And so this is going to get access to the first emoji, or first reaction rather. And that's why I mentioned that future ones won't actually matter. It's only going to care about the first reaction. A quick tip is that you might want to disable people from adding their own reactions in here through the permissions. If that is disabled for the channel, people will still be able to add to existing reactions, which makes this a lot cleaner. Going back, now that we have the first one, we want to call .fetch, which will make sure that we have the most up-to-date information. We could use the cache, but that's not something I suggest because sometimes Discord won't actually have the information loaded. So .fetch, and then whatever this result is going to be an object that has a user's property, and that's why we're destructuring it here. So now, again, we want to call .fetch with on the users. So I can create a constant called reaction users. Set this equal to users.fetch. Now we have to use await here. So await users.fetch. And then we're going to try and convert this into an array of possible winners. So constant possible winners is going to equal reaction users.array, which will convert this into an array. And then after that, we can say const winner. And this is going to equal possible winners. Now we need to actually access a random index from this array. So we can do that with math.floor. And then within this function call, we can say math.random times possible winners.length. And so this is going to be the syntax to get a random element from the possible winners array. Now at this point, we can console log the winner. I'm then going to save this and restart my bot. Going into Discord, I can then run end giveaway. I'm going to automatically detect the previous message, and then in this case, the tutorial actually won. So currently me and the tutorial have that. Let me run this again, end giveaway. The tutorial won again. Let's try that one more time. All right, so I'm finally won there, and so it's going to randomly select this. Now, obviously, we don't want the bot to have a possible win. So if we look inside these objects, we see bot is true for the bot and bot is false for me. So one thing we can do, which is why we actually converted this into an array in the first place, we can use .filter, which is going to allow us to return true or false upon every single element in the array, and that's going to determine if that stays within the array or not. So this is going to give us a callback, and inside the arguments for this callback, we are going to have a user, and we can simply return not user.bot. I can save this, I can restart my bot. Going back into here, I can do end giveaway, and it's going to select me, and it will select me every single time. Because the bot is no longer eligible, the array is only me. So at this point, you can tag the user, you can have the bot private message yourself, and I do have videos on that, and you can go whichever direction you want when it comes to actually announcing the giveaway. And so this is how you're going to create a very basic giveaway system using Discord.js. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.